Hello everyone, Emmanuel here. Today, we're going to see how to send geometry using the live link. With the live link, you can send materials and geometry, but until now, it was locked to only be able to send information between Substance Painter and other 3D apps. But with this version, this changes, because now you can send 3D geometry between any capable 3D app. I mention capable 3D apps because Substance Designer can receive geometry, but not really send it. For example, if we want to send geometry from Maya to Blender, or from Cinema 4D to Maya, or from Blender to Toolbag, you just need to select the geometry, select the destination app, and click Send. And this will work in most cases, but with some apps there are some caveats. And today we'll see the specific ones of Substance Painter. So let's get started. Let's talk first about sending geometry from Painter to any other 3D app. To do it, once you have an existing project open and an available client, meaning that there is at least one app connected, you'll see in the Set section the option to send the 3D model. If you enable it, immediately three options will appear. First, the source that can be either Substance Painter or imported file. The first one, Substance Painter, means that it will send the geometry that is actually saved inside the Painter file. The second one, imported file, means that it will send the original geometry file that was used when you created the Painter project. I added this option because while in most cases the geometry from the Painter file will work fine, if you are using UDIMS, sometimes the geometry might break. One important thing to notice is that if you use the imported file option, it will only work if you have the original file you used to create your Painter project in the same location of your system. Meaning that if I use this file called UDIMS FBX to create my Painter file, the file needs to remain there in the same path. In this case, desktop test live link FBX. Another important thing is that if you change the name of the texture set in Painter, that information is not changed in the geometry. For example, with the JToad sample project, the texture set name is Toad, but the actual assigned material tag is different once you import the geometry into any other 3D app. The name parameter will be used in most apps as the name of the imported geometry, in case you need to keep a standard nomenclature. And with format, you can select which type of temporary file you want to use, usually either OBJ or FBX. Now, let's talk about receiving geometry in Painter. When you send geometry to Painter, there are two scenarios. Either Painter has an open project or not. If there is no open project, Painter will simply create one, using the project setup data established in the config tab that defines the normal format to be used inside Painter, the default resolution for the texture sets, the type of tangents, and the type of project that needs to be created either with a default workflow or with a UDIMS workflow. There is also a template path in case you use a template to initialize your projects. And finally, we have three checkboxes. If you want to import cameras to have them available in your project, if you want to close a project if new geometry is sent, instead of reloading the project if it's already open, and preserve strokes if you're reloading geometry. These two are the ones that you want to keep an eye the most. If you have preserved strokes, you will have more information once you reload the geometry, specifically on handmade strokes. But if your geometry changes a lot, it will cause an issue. If you disable preserved strokes, the update of geometry will work even if the 3D model changes a lot. And the close current project if geometry is sent when enabled, it will do what it says. Close the current project and create a new one. But if you disable it, which is the default behavior, it will update the geometry with a new 3D model inside the project. Remember, for every action of the plugin, we will get some information in Painter's log window, the book-like icon on the right side of the UI. So if you have any issues, more information about the problem might be there. And if you need help, don't hesitate to contact me via Discord, and I will help you as soon as possible.